Doctors have said that 19-year-old Anthony Davis is still growing. That's good considering the 6'10 rookie is playing big for the Hornets through the first 2 weeks of his NBA career. But over the last two games, Davis has experienced some growing pains, scoring just 8 points in each of the Hornets' back-to-back losses. Well, against the Milwaukee Bucks, those growing pains went away, at least for tonight. Davis, 28 points, 11 rebounds, and a bounce-back game. The Bees snatched a 27-25 lead after the first quarter. Watch out for Mike Dunleavy Jr., though.
He'll shoot your eyes out.
4 3-pointers, 16 points in the second quarter. Bucks score 60 in the first half. All of those threes are great, but Gravis Vasquez says, I can do you one better. The three and the foul. 4-point play ties it up at 82 in the third. Vasquez, 13 points, 11 assists, though. The Hornets could not defend the Bucks from outside. Milwaukee hit 13 three-pointers on 52% shooting from long range and win 117-113. The Rebels do not want to be the same Ole Miss. Last year, they were crushed by LSU 52-3 at home, part of an embarrassing stretch of 7 straight losses. Last year's results and LSU's 2 losses this year coming against top 10 teams be easy for the Tigers to look past Ole Miss. But Les Miles has said all week that despite the Rebels' modest 5-5 record, they're a much improved team that could compete in Death Valley. Coach was absolutely right. Bo Wallace says, I'm a quarterback, and I'm faster than all you guys. 58 yards for the score. Ole Miss takes the 7-0 lead. The Tigers have a stable of running backs. Somehow, true freshman Jeremy Hill has made his way to the top of the depth chart. We see why here. Game all tied up at 7. That's not the last time we'll hear from Jeremy. It's also not the last time we heard from Mr. Wallace. Earlier, we saw the legs. Now we see the arm. Dante Moncrief, 56 yards, and the Rebels jump ahead 21-17 at the break. Fourth quarter, Moncrief, Wallace, connect again. 30 yards this time around for a second score. Wallace, 310 yards on the day. Unranked Ole Miss looking poised for an upset. Head by 7 with 10 minutes to go.
But there's a playmaker alert.
NOLA native Odell Beckham, 89 yards for the go-ahead score. Still, the game is tied at 35 apiece with 40 seconds to go. I told you we would see the fresh and clean freshman Hill again. He only had 77 yards, but every single one was tough and counted like these to seal the victory for the first down here. Then he plunges in for the game-winning score, his third touchdown with 10 seconds to go. Tigers hold on to win 41-35. Senior day for the Green Wave, East Carolina paying a visit to the Dome. Quarterback Ryan Griffin playing his final home game, and he made it count. 293 yards, 13 and a touch come to Xavier Rush. Green Wave ahead 7-0. ECU only has 1 loss in conference play this year. This is why. Reggie Bullock, tough running up the middle. 172 yards on the ground for the Pirates. This score gives them a 21-13 lead. Griffin, not done yet. His second touchdown, a beauty to Wilson Van Hooser. Tulane, not enough firepower, though. They fall 28-23 and are 2-9 this year. The Saints' bend-but-don't-break approach on defense has reached an extreme this season. While the black and gold are last in the NFL in total defense and second to last against the run and the pass, they're actually first overall in the red zone. Saints interim head coach Joe Vitt says that's no fluke.
Any other place that I've been, we never spent the amount of time that we spend here in the red zone and in what we call the tight red zone from the 12-yard line in. It goes all the way back to the first OTA sessions that we have in the summer and carries right through to training camp. We dedicate a large portion of our practice every Friday to get ready for that situation.
Saints red zone success will be put to the test again tomorrow at Oakland against a Raiders offense that's actually 6th in the NFL in passing. Kickoff set for 3:05 tomorrow. How about those Saints? 0-4 start. Now they're 1 win away from reaching 500. Maybe the playoffs still in the picture.
I think they are. And if they play like they did last week, they absolutely deserve to be there. Where were those guys? We'll be right back.